evolving, so as we get more information, we'll get it out. But this is the preliminary information as we have it. At about 3:45 this afternoon, fire engine number 3 was southbound on Rhodes Avenue, crossing the intersection at a green light. There was the SUV was westbound on West Exchange Street, and they went through, according to witness statements, independent witness statements, went through a red light and struck the engine as it was going through the green light. We understand at this time there were 8 individuals taken to area hospitals, 3 of which were firefighters that occupied the engine. There were 3 firefighters on the engine. All 3 were taken to area hospitals. It's my understanding that all 3 firefighters are being treated for minor injuries, and we anticipate hopefully that they'll be making a full recovery. It's my understanding too, we're still trying to work on driver and passenger information, but I can confirm at this time, unfortunately, there were 2 fatalities from the SUV. We're still working on identification of the individuals in the car, and specifically those that were fatalities of the SUV. I can confirm that one of the fatalities was a 16-year-old female. We still haven't identified, and we're still working on the other fatality. We're working on identifying and getting ages of the driver and the other passengers of the car. So we're still working on that. I don't even have numbers of how many were in the car at this time.
Doing our math, 3 firefighters, 8 people have been taken to the hospital, 5 occupants. That simple math tells me there are 5 occupants of the SUV.
And that's what we're working on now. I mean, your simple math is probably correct, but until I have actual confirmation that somebody didn't leave the SUV, walk away, whatever the case may be, we're going to stay with 3 firefighters injured. That was the number of occupants in the engine. And we know that 5 were taken from the SUV, 2 of which were fatalities. But that's preliminary information. We don't know that it was just 5 people in that vehicle.
Do you know if the driver had his or her license?
That's something we're trying to confirm. We've got a lot of conflicting information as to the age of the driver, whether the driver had a driver's license or not. Our traffic reconstruction unit has just pulled up on the scene. Because of the fatalities, as you well know, we bring in our traffic reconstruction specialists. They specialize in these type of incidences involving traffic fatalities. They will follow up from our street traffic officers with the information they have. But at this time, I can't confirm information on the driver, whether the driver did have a valid driver's license, whether the driver was an underage driver or not. We're still trying to work on that.
Chief Clarence Tucker, I want to ask a question about the fire engine. Engine number 3, where is it from? What house, what engine house here?
Well, actually, engine 3 is actually on Maple Street is where they're from. They were not en route to an emergency at the time of the incident. They were en route to go do training. I can tell you that this is, as you can tell, it's a horrific event, and our prayers and thoughts are with the families of everyone that's involved here. And we'll get you more information as it's available to us.
Chief, how many? We know that 3 firefighters were taken to be examined. How many firefighters altogether were there on the engine?
There were 3 firefighters on the engine.
Just total. 3 firefighters on the engine?
Correct.
Okay. Were they all in the cab or?
There were 2 up front and then 1 in the back.
Okay.
There's typically a driver, an officer in the front, and then a 3rd firefighter in the back.
Some witnesses saying that the truck went through a yellow light, not a green. Have you heard anything like that?
I don't know anything about that. That's still under investigation. And as we get more information, we'll let you know.
In any case, there was no lights or sirens. They were not on their way to an emergency.
That is correct.
So, okay.
Do we know the conditions of the other people that were in the SUV who survived?
We don't have conditions on any of the remaining individuals at this time. We'll continue to, we actually have officers at the various hospitals getting statements from those that are able to give a statement. So as the night progresses, hopefully we can update conditions on the remaining individuals, update the conditions on the firefighters that were in the engine. But at this time, everything's still preliminary.
You know, no idea if this was distraction driving or anything. Is any of the witnesses said they were anything like that?
Just way too early. That will have to come in the reconstruction investigation. Way too early for that. To be able to answer that question.
You know who went to which hospitals or which?
We know that some of them were underage and went to Children's Hospital. How many? I'm still trying to sort that out. I think all 3 the main hospitals, a couple to Children's, some to Akron City, and some to Akron General, from my understanding.
So 3 or 4 children in the SUV, do you know?
I'm still putting that together, Bob.
Okay.